Now, verse 10, when they saw the star, they rejoiced with exceeding great joy. Now, when they arrived, Jesus was not in a stable back of an inn. When they were coming to the house, you see, the great movement of people in the city of Bethlehem had all now dissipated. They had all gone back to their homes. The enrollment was over. But you see, this little baby had been born, and they couldn't move him for a while. And I'm of the opinion that a trip of a little fella that age would have jeopardized his life. And so they had stayed there. And when they were coming to the house, and in the meantime they had moved into a house, they saw the young child with Mary his mother, and they fell down and worshipped him. And when they had opened their treasures, they presented unto him gold and frankincense and myrrh. Now, this is a remarkable passage of Scripture, and I want you to notice it. Most of the pictures I've seen show the wise men coming into the stable. Well, unless Joseph pointed that stable out to them, they never knew where it was. They didn't go there. They came to the house. And when they saw the young child with Mary, his mother, notice how accurately this stated, they fell down and worshiped who? They worshiped him. If there ever was a time when Mary should have been worshiped, this was it. But they didn't worship her. They were wise men. And they worshiped him. And when they had opened their treasures, they presented unto him gold and frankincense and myrrh. And I think one of the very interesting things that you have here is the fact that it is second coming. And Isaiah is the one that tells us this in Isaiah 66. The multitude of camels shall cover thee, the dromedaries of Midian and Ephah. All they from Sheba shall come. They shall bring gold and incense, and they shall show forth the praises of the Lord. Now, that's a prophecy of his second coming. What's left out? Myrrh. Why didn't they bring myrrh? That speaks of his death. When he comes the second time, nothing will speak of his death. Gold speaks of his birth. He's born a king. Frankincense speaks of the fragrance of his life. And myrrh here speaks of his death. All of it's wrapped up in the gifts that were brought to him at this time. But myrrh will not be brought the last time, the next time he comes, because the next time he won't come to die upon a cross for the sins of the world. Now, verse 12 says, and being warned of God in a dream that they should not return to Herod, they departed into their own country another way. And when they were departed, behold, the angel of the Lord appeared to Joseph in a dream, saying, arise, take the young child and his mother, and flee into Egypt, and be thou there until I bring thee word, for Herod will seek the young child to destroy him. Now, the wise men assumed that Herod was sincere when he said he wanted to know about the child, and he'd come down and worship him. Well, if he came down, he would slay the child, of course. Had not the angel of the Lord warned them, the wise men would have gone back by Jerusalem and given the good news to Herod, and believe me, he would have killed the child. Now, we find that they are alerted, and they go another direction to their own country. They could continue south, down to Hebron, and then cross over the south of the Dead Sea. They'd be out of the range of Herod altogether. Now the angel of the Lord also appeared to Joseph and told him it's time now to get out of Bethlehem because Herod is going to attempt to kill the child. And now Joseph, he took the young child and his mother by night and departed into Egypt. And he was there until the death of Herod, that it might be fulfilled which was spoken of the Lord by the prophet, saying, out of Egypt have I called my son. And that's Hosea 11:1. And that's a marvelous prophecy because it has a historical basis. Out of Egypt the son was called, which was the nation. And out of Egypt, the son was called, who is a person. And this person here, and this is the prophecy. He went down there and stayed, Joseph did, and took the young child and the mother. Now we read verse 16, then Herod, when he saw that he was mocked of the wise men, was exceeding wroth, and sent forth and slew all the children that were in Bethlehem and in all the coasts thereof, from 2 years old and under, according to the time which he had diligently inquired of the wise men. A part of what I'm going to say now is supposition, but part, of course, is based upon good solid fact here. We made the statement before that the wise men did not arrive at the same time that the shepherds did. The wise men came later. Now, I know in a church pageant that down one aisle the shepherds come, and down the other aisle, why, the wise men come. They didn't get that close together, and they didn't come at the same time. The wise men arrived, and we found out last time, verse 11, when they were coming to the house. They'd moved into the house by then. Now, when Herod had inquired of them diligently what time the star appeared, and I suppose that they said, well, it was about a year ago, because you see, these wise men came from all quarters of the east, and I think they met in a certain place and then made their trek across the desert and came to Jerusalem. And that would consume a great deal of time. In that day, they didn't travel by jet. They traveled by camel, and some camels have one hump and some have two humps. And at best, you see, it'd be either one-cylinder or two-cylinder job. So they didn't get there until quite a bit afterward. Now, Herod had asked when they saw the star, but when he slays all the children in that area from 2 years old and under, I would say this, and this is the part that's supposition. Herod is so angry, and he's actually mad, by the way, that the wise man didn't come back and tell him, and he sees that he's been taken in by the wise men, that they were not cleverer than he thought they were, but they had a message from the Lord, because they would have gone by and told him. But now, in his anger, I think just doubled. He said, well, if they said it was a year ago they saw the star, we'll just double it and make it 2 years and kill all the children.